Hello everyone, and welcome to Nettle, the best platform around for distance learning in business, finance, economics, and much, much more. My name is Sava, and today we're going to cover valuation multiples, a fundamental analysis technique that uses financial disclosure to value stocks of publicly listed companies. Without further ado, let's look at our spreadsheet where we've got two most famous UK energy stocks, Royal Dutch Shell and BP, British Petroleum. And to apply valuation multiples to assign fair values to stocks so that we can determine whether we should buy them or sell them, we need to undertake fundamental analysis for the comparables. Companies that come from the same industry, so oil and gas, and that are of comparable size, so they have similarly large market capitalizations. To do that, I got 20 other energy companies from Western Europe that have current market capitalization of greater than £1 billion. And for all of our companies, I've got some basic fundamental data from their accounts. As we can see, the only indicators we need are total assets, total liabilities, the number of shares outstanding, and earnings per share. Total assets are in millions of pounds, so how much assets, property, equipment, inventories, cash, and so on and so forth the company currently possesses. Total liabilities, how much debt in various forms the company currently holds. Both assets and liabilities are in millions of pounds again. Number of shares outstanding, how many shares are currently in circulation, held by various investors, by the company itself, by retail investors, people like you and me, by institutional investors, funds and investment banks, and so on and so forth. So this is in millions of shares. And earnings per share. So how much does the company earn per its share in pounds per share? And using just those four fundamental indicators, as well as the current market price in pounds, we can decide whether we should buy or sell Royal Dutch and BP. Exciting enough, isn't it? So, first, what we need to do is we need to calculate the book value of equity. So, how much own assets the company has to back up the value of its stocks. To do that, we need to apply the very, very famous accounting identity, that is, assets minus liabilities always equals owner's equity. To do that, we just need to have our total asset and subtract total liabilities. And we'll get book value of equity for our two candidate companies that we're trying to value, as well as their comparables. This is total book value of equity in millions of British pounds. As we try to undertake valuation on the level of an individual share, we need to calculate book value per share. That's straightforward enough. We've got total book value of equity in millions of pounds and amount of share outstanding in millions of shares. So to carry on, we just need to divide book value of equity by the number of shares outstanding, and we'll get book value per share in pounds. So we can see over here already that the book value per share of Royal Dutch is higher than its market price, and it might suggest that, well, maybe we should buy it or not. But again, just comparing book value per share to market price might not be the best idea, as what is valued on the market is not just the current book value of assets the company owns, it is also the growth prospects that the company has. So to do that, to carry out our analysis more accurately, we need to figure out what is the ratio of book value per share and market price for all of our comparable companies, and then we can decide whether our two companies, Royal Dutch and BP, are overvalued or undervalued. So we need to calculate book value per share for all of our companies, both the companies that we are valuing and their comparables. Again, dividing book value of equity by the number of shares outstanding and getting book value per share in pounds. And now it's quite straightforward of how do we do proceed to the price to book ratio. The price to book ratio is the relationship between the current market price of a stock and its book value. So how well is the market price of the share is backed up by assets that the company owns that are not attributable to its debt, that it can back up by shareholders' equity. So price to book, quite obviously, is the ratio between market price and book value per share. And we calculate price to book ratio for all of our comparable companies. We can see that the price to book ratio varies substantially across our comparable companies, from slightly above 50% for Subsea, all the way up to over 4 for Nestle. It means that there are some variations in price to book ratios across comparables, but overall the fluctuations are not that wide. Again, then we need to move on to price to earnings ratio. Well, price to earnings ratio is one of the most common fundamental valuation multiples you will see applied in investment practice or financial advice, and it has to do with the ratio between market price and earnings per share. The most intuitive explanation of this indicator is how many years would it take for the company to pay out the current market price of its stock using only the earnings that the company generates. If you divide earnings by price, you'll have earnings yield, but most commonly, just for convention purposes, the reverse is used. So we divide price to earnings and see how many years would it take for the company to pay out its value in earnings. We divide market price onto earnings per share, and we can see that it will take around 12 years to the French oil company Total to pay out its value to its shareholders in earnings. And then we apply this ratio to all of our companies and see that it changes for different comparables, but again, the fluctuations are not that significant. Now we can proceed to the valuation of two our candidate companies, Royal Dutch and BP. To do that, we need to calculate the fair price to book and price to earnings ratio for those companies. And the fair ratio, price to book or price to earnings, is usually just the average of those indicators across comparable companies. So remember, we got large energy companies in Western Europe, very, very close comparables to UK energy companies. So to proceed with our valuation, we need to calculate the average of price to book and the average of price to earnings. Now we can see that the fair relationship, for the fair ratio between market price and book value per share for our companies should be around 1.85. And also the fair price to earnings ratio for them should be 16. So if those companies would be on par with their comparables, every pound of book value of equity should correspond to £1.85 in market value, and those companies should be able to pay out their market value in earnings in a little bit more than 16 years. Now we can calculate fair valuations of those stocks. To do that, we can use the formulas over here. The fair value of a company is its fair price to book, calculated across comparables, times its own book value per share. So for Royal Dutch, we multiply the fair price to book, got from comparables, onto its book value per share. And we see that the fair value of Royal Dutch, according to price to book ratio at least, is £17.5, which is much, much higher than its current market price, which might be interpreted as an early signal that Royal Dutch Shell is undervalued and you should buy it. Applying the same measure to BP, we multiply the fair price to book ratio by book value per share of BP, and we get slightly above £7, given the fact that current price per share for British Petroleum is £4.63. This is also a quite distinct signal to buy. But again, and this is very important in valuations, you should apply a number of different measures and see if the signals that they've given you are consistent. If all of the measures are telling you to buy, you can be sure that you will be that trade that you are undertaking will be profitable. So we multiply price to earnings for Royal Dutch using the formula over here onto its earnings per share, and we get £34, which is lower than the valuation according to price to book, but still higher than the market price of £21.5. And for BP, we multiply the fair price to earnings ratio onto its own earnings per share, and we get £5.68. We can see that both valuation multiples, price to book ratio and price to earnings ratio, tell us that those companies are undervalued. Their market price lies under their fair fundamental value. So it can be interpreted as a strong signal to buy. Of course, this is not meant to be investment advice. This is just an illustration of the application of those very, very common, simple yet useful valuation multiple methods of fundamental analysis to guide your analysis, to guide your investment decisions, and to familiarize yourself with some of the most frequently used techniques in asset management. Hope it was helpful. Please remember to subscribe, leave a like on this video if you found it helpful, and suggest in the comments below what do you want me to cover in the next video. See you around.